In this video tutorial, I will show you how to make this button with bullion stitches. Those buttons are seen in Romanian lace only, but since they are beautiful and we can also use them, I think, in Irish lace. So I will teach you how to make this button and crochet around the button bullion stitches. So first you will need 4 or 5 millimeters a needle or handle of a hook, if you have hook like that, and wrap around the handle or needle thread 10-15 times, depends on how puffy your and thick your button you want to be. So I have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. And that's it. I will use only 15. Take this coil of the needle carefully. Pick up your hook. I will use for this button 0.9 millimeters hook, and my thread is a Perle cotton number 8. And we will crochet single crochet stitches around the button. Make sure that you do not see anything here on the back of the button, that it look nice and neat. So continue crochet single crochet stitches around the button. I will pick up my prepared piece and we will continue together. So your button will continue. You will have this. This is your right side and this is wrong side. And continue. I still have to make a few more stitches. And we will finish this round of single crochet stitches with a slip stitch at the end. So I made one more stitch. This is how it will look like on the wrong side and right side. We'll make slip stitch here. And at this time, at this point, you don't need any more your hook. You will need to pick up knit picker, insert into the stitch, and we will make first bullion stitch. So make sure that this first stitch is nice and tight on the hook, on the neck of a hook, and move it to the handle all the way. Wrap thread around the hook 15 or 18 or 20 times, depends on how big your button is. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. After that, grab thread with the hook and move this hook through all this wrapped thread, wrapped coil of thread. I'm trying to show you that you would see how it looks like, but I wouldn't recommend you to do what I just did. And I'll show you later in the next stitch. So we did that. Then hook into the button, into the opening of the button. Pick up thread with the hook and move it through. Now you have 2 stitches on the hook. Crochet them together. So now I will show this one more time. So here is our bullion stitch around the button, the first one. One more time. So the first stitch, make sure it's nice and tight, close to the handle, and wrap thread around from 15, 18 or 20 times, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Now with the thread, open that little piece right here and move the hook all the way. When you move the hook, that little piece will close, as you see, and move it through all those stitches. What I said not to recommend to do, I would recommend you to close with your thumb and hold this stitch together with two fingers, thumb and a middle finger, hold them together, then move thread through the coil. You don't need to see it, I just showed you first time what's going on. Now make sure when you will go through the button with the hook, this little piece is locked, because you can damage your previous hooks, and the button itself was that little pointy and sharp piece. So make sure it's closed. Now move the hook inside the button in the opening with the thread. You can see the thread actually can open that hook, but on its own. With the thread, open that, pick up thread and move it through. Okay, I did something wrong. Somehow my button reversed. Okay, one more time. Go inside the button, pick up thread and crochet. Move threads through. Now pick up again thread and move it through. And again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So pick up thread with the hook and move the hook. You can help with your middle index finger holding all this thread on the hook, and every time you move the thread in the hook all the way to the end, you'll see that this little piece will close the hook, allowing you to grab the thread, secure this thread, and you can move thread through all this wrapping, through this coil of thread. So this is how it will look like, but please hold them together, it's just for the video. Now close this and go with the hook into the button, into the opening, grab thread with the hook and move it to the front. You have two stitches on the hook. You will notice that this hook will be totally wide open, that's fine. And as you grab the thread, and when you move hook closer to those stitches, you can see what's going on with that little piece. It's closing on its own, closing the hook, allowing thread to go through. And it's open again. So this way, crochet as many stitches you can fit here. To close the button completely. So I prefer to hold my coil of thread with the fingers of the left hand that way. The stitches over here will look nice and neat. They will be easier to, and sometimes you can lose this, that's okay, just don't panic, pick up with a regular hook whatever you lost and fix it, and then again use your knit picker. So continue crocheting bullion stitches around, and I will pick up my next piece that already almost finished. This is how it will look like. And you look at the, once in a while, look at the front of your button and see how many stitches you still can fit here. Look like I can fit here 2 more bullion stitches. So continue, and I'll show you how to finish this button. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Now pick up thread with the hook and move through the coil. Close the hook and go inside the opening of a button. Grab the thread, pull this thread through the button here. Have 2 stitches on the hook, grab the thread and crochet 2 together. And so I will make 1 more bullion stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Make a bullion stitch. Close the hook and insert the hook into the opening of a button. Grab the thread, pull this thread through like this, and crochet those 2 stitches together like this. And so when you are satisfied with the number of bullion stitches in your around your button, now you can cut your thread off. Before you will finish, first of all, you can remove knit picker, pick up regular hook and finish with a slip stitch here. Pick up stitch on the left. Make a slip stitch. And now weave in your thread into a tapestry needle. And well, I'm calling tapestry needle, but we are crocheting with a fine thread. Just make sure you have an appropriate needle for that. So insert the thread into the needle and weave in thread right inside the button on the back. I always recommend to go and make 1 or 2 rounds when you weave in your thread, just to secure your thread that it will not unravel your work. And when you're done, you can cut thread off and your work is finished. Go in the front and make sure that this all look nice. And there we have the button. This is how it works.